To the moon in 3 days, to Mars in years. When will the era of fast space travel begin? One might think that 50 years after the last manned landing on the moon, technology would have made these missions faster and more accessible. Yet, instead of rapid interplanetary travel, we celebrate private rocket launches and the continued operation of the International Space Station, ISS. Why is that? Flying to the moon, faster or cheaper? During the space race, Soviet and American engineers burned enormous amounts of fuel to reach the moon as quickly as possible. However, today's approach is different. The priority is no longer speed, but efficiency. By using gravitational maneuvers and ion propulsion, spacecraft can significantly reduce fuel consumption, but at the cost of a much longer journey. For example, the Smart One mission, launched by the European Space Agency, took 13 months to reach the moon, compared to just 70 hours for Apollo. The probe gradually spiraled away from Earth using its ion thruster until it reached a Lagrange point where the gravitational forces of the moon and Earth balanced out. Why does it take so long? The moon is located between 363,000 and 405,000 kilometers from Earth, depending on its position in orbit. In the past, space missions followed a direct transfer trajectory, allowing astronauts to reach the moon in just 3 days. However, this method required large amounts of fuel, making it extremely expensive. For instance, the Soviet Union launched Luna 1, which reached the moon's distance in just 34 hours. But due to a miscalculation, the spacecraft missed the moon and drifted into deep space, never to return. And what about Mars? If traveling to the moon requires careful planning, reaching Mars is an even bigger challenge. The Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter took 7 months to reach the Red Planet. But for a crewed spacecraft that needs to return to Earth, the journey could take years. On top of that, there are numerous technical and biological challenges to overcome, such as radiation exposure, long-term life support systems, ensuring a safe return trip. Clarification: what was Luna 1? Luna 1 was a Soviet robotic space probe designed to study the moon and interplanetary space. It was the first spacecraft in history to achieve escape velocity from Earth, meaning it completely broke free from Earth's gravity and became the first human-made object to enter heliocentric orbit, effectively making it the first artificial satellite of the Sun. Although it missed the moon, Luna 1 provided valuable scientific data on space conditions beyond Earth's influence, marking a crucial milestone in the early space exploration era.